Hey, Elsie. I'm Caroline Deanis.
And I'm Manit Mander.
And here are your Indian Insights for Wednesday, April 16th, 2014.
Okay. Any senior or junior still wanting a prom ticket, please see Mrs. Loden in C329.
There will be practice exams for AP Government Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays after school in room C307.
NHS current members can pick up a list of upcoming events in C122. We will not be having an official meeting this month.
Hey, you want to learn about LCTV members?
Yeah, let's check it out.
Okay.
Round two of LCTV Fun Facts. Let's check it out.
Hi, my name's Maddie Gomez, and I play ukulele, I pole vault, but most importantly, I had a seashell removed from my ear surgically when I was 3 years old.
My name's Chrissy Addison, and I'm addicted to Dairy Queen. Even some of the workers know me by name.
Hi, I'm Caroline Deanis, and I can do a mean impersonation of Kermit the Frog.
Hello, I'm Kermit the Frog here. Here's my wife, Miss Piggy.
Hi, my name's Lana Carrington, and I can juggle.
Hello, my name is Emma Hupp, and I can rap all of the real Slim Shady and half of Rap God. Those were some really nice fun facts.
What an interesting group of people. We're all awesome.
There will be practice exams for AP Micro and Macroeconomics every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday after school in C303.
The American Sign Language Club will meet today from 2:10 to 3 o'clock in the temporary library.
Tyler Payne caught up with Ugana Nwanunu regarding her passion for art. Let's see what she had to say.
Hi, I'm Ugana Nwanunu. I am a junior at Lake Central, and I love to portray messages through my art. When I first started drawing, it was more for the vanity of it. Learning how to incorporate new skills in different mediums, whether it be pencil, pen, paint, or charcoal, and getting better at it and learning how to do things such as portray glass and how that disfigures forms. And as I found out what I could do with it, I then thought about how I could make it mine, add my own style, my own twist into art that people see every day. As I got older and not only embraced the Nigerian culture that my family came from and the Black American culture that I grew up around, I felt like incorporating the bad and the good of both cultures made my art into what it is, its own individual and unique style. Taking social issues like the Trayvon Martin case and then incorporating it into the piece like I did, which is untitled because there's no word, at least in the English language that I can fathom, that describes both the physical, emotional, and other types of pain that go into that case. Instead of clean strokes, I chose to go with the more chaotic style because it's exactly what that case was. It twisted a young boy into something that he most likely wasn't. He doesn't even have a mouth in the painting because he didn't have a voice to speak. The next piece that I have took the Black American culture that I grew up in and the Nigerian culture that I was raised to be familiar with and put it in one. It shows the African wear to an extent as far as the head wrap goes and the patterns on the clothing to show that that's where Black cultures did stem from. But the woman in the piece, although she physically has Black features, whether it be the fullness of her lips or the roundness of her nose, does not have brown, Black, caramel skin. She has blue skin to portray that no matter what color we are still Black, that it's more than just a color, contrary to the name. It has more to do with what makes us, as far as our history, as far as our struggles and our greatness also. So with age, I learned to embrace the Nigerian and even more specifically Igbo culture that my parents instilled in me because it is what they grew up with. A lot of my pieces then became to include symbols of African culture, whether it be the head wrap scarf that a lot of women wear called the gele, or the drums that a lot of music even today is based on. I'd like to thank my parents for instilling Igbo culture in me. I like to thank my friends for not only supporting me, but showing me the bad and the good in Black American culture. And lastly, I'd like to thank my high school art teacher, Ms. Yeager, for showing me what I can do with art and what I can hope to be able to do one day.
Great job, Ugana. You're very talented.
Representatives from Success Vocation School, Barbering, Cosmetology, and Massage Therapy in Maryville will be visiting after school on Wednesday, April 30th. Interested students should report to the guidance office at 2:15.
Practice exams for APUSH can be taken in C304 on Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 6:30 a.m. If you have any questions, see Mr. Zelonik.
Students interested in being an academic letter winner officer should pick up an application from Mr. Harnish in C217. Applications are due to Mr. Harnish by May 2nd.
Hearts for Hope sign-up sheets are located in the main office and various classrooms. Contact Sabrina Wider with any questions.
The next blood drive will be held on Friday, April 25th. All donors must be at least 16 years old and have signed permission slips. Stop by the American Cross table in the town square during lunch if you're interested in signing up.
And that's it for your Indian Insights. I'm Manit Mander.
I'm Caroline Deanis.
And have a great day.
Don't tell them what to do. Stay fresh, Elsie.